many of our members in the three cities in the UK, London, Birmingham, and Glasgow, they come together to look at what's happening around migration, to look at the messages, to look at to exchange learning from the activities that they have been doing in the cities, and to also develop the strategy and the activities for migrant voice messages we want to get out.
Very complex is the difference between migrants and refugees. There's a lot of debate on that, so I think a lot of abuse about that issue. I've been going down the Balkan route with refugees and migrants over the last few weeks, so that's one of the issues. The different places people come from, what's happening to the Dublin Protocol, which is the EU system, which means that people are supposed to be processed in their first country of entry into the European Union. And then 1951 UN Convention, how that's being changed. And also, I think, Europe, but also specifically Britain, and how Britain is handling this growing crisis. So there is no more apt moment to have this discussion than now.
But we've got to use this moment in the sun to gear up for the struggle that lies ahead. It's great that we've got substantial, serious movement on Syrian refugees, but actually Syrian refugees are still a minority of the refugees we see in the UK, and we must not allow our focus to drop or be diverted in any way.
Europe, at a time when our fellow human beings need our compassion and humanity most, we have responded with building more walls.
Subject of migration, migrants, I should say, asylum seekers and refugees, is near and dear to my heart. And with your permission, Lindsay, I would like to ask for a reflective moment of silence to remember those who perished on their way to a safe space.
The scale of the forced displacement globally is at the record high levels, at levels unseen in the post-World War II era. Just to summarise it briefly, we're talking about 60 million people in the situation of forced displacement globally.
The main news stories were this one, the refugee crisis, and the Director General of MI5 saying there needs to be a new surveillance law. Now that's as hot a topic almost as the refugee crisis.
I think there is a vast amount of evidence that e-migrants benefit the country, the economy, but also society. There's a ream of studies from the Commission, from the OECD, from various universities like UCL, that have concluded that there is no evidence of widespread benefit of tourism. So while there may be cases of fraud here and there that need to be combated, there is no evidence of widespread benefit of tourism.
The situation is getting worse and worse over the last few years, and it's going to continue to get worse as we go to the referendum.
Freedom from war and fascism meant freedom for movement. Freedom for the movement of goods, that was sort of the easiest, it really came first. Freedom for the movement of services, that was more difficult, it's pretty much there. Freedom for the movement of capital, well that came, though it's been suspended in the last few weeks. And of course, freedom for the movement of people. And that really, really matters, because people are more important than fridges.
This is no longer about EU citizens moving. This is about how do we get this back, as Theresa May put it, to the whole national social security, all of this free movement, to its original purpose being about workers. So it's no longer about citizens, it's about workers.
Apologies, and I wanted to move to London because of its diversity that you can't find important, unfortunately. So, you know, I think it's very important to kind of look at different reasons why people migrate as well, so that this place, you know, the narrative is not so monolithic as it happens to be usually.
Um, what was happening in South Africa was we trained nurse nurses for 4 years. And on the third year, we had workshops from British companies coming to pitch their ideas about nursing in the UK and how different it will be. So when I finished my fourth year, I went straight to work as an intensive care nurse. And they said they wanted people with redefined skills or something like that. It was more of what was promised. It was more of you'll have better human rights, you will move faster within the pay scale, we'll recognize your professional qualifications. If you want to go to university, you'll be substituted. I think it's such a shame that someone is sitting in the office behind the desk and they don't have a clue what's going on in the lower ground. Migrants have built the NHS. Migrants rule the NHS. We are not in leading positions because it takes 2-3 years to get from one brand to another in nursing. However, the system doesn't prepare you for the reality of a different country, because when you get to a different country, no matter what your qualifications are, you are a migrant.